Is this instrument manometer? First question of the day. Is this manometer capable of finding out absolute pressure? This instrument is used, this gauge is used to measure what?
Starting from one end, convert all the pressures into heads of water. Here,
HA, pressure at A is nothing but HA, going in the horizontal direction, no variation. Coming downwards, which is this liquid, specific gravity 0.9, SA in rho, I'll name this as H1, manometric deflection as H, and this I'll name as H2. So, SA, H1, you are still coming downwards, positive, SM, this is SM is equal to 30.6. SM into how much will they get later? SM into H, and then going upwards, that is minus how much? Yes, which liquid is that? I do not know, so I will answer that SB into H2O. Do not forget to write this pressure, that A is exerting certain pressure, that is minus how much? I will write it as PB by rho W G is equal to C. Clear? Now, what is HA? We will say it later. HA should be converted later into PA. Correct? HA plus SA and then 0.9 into 0.1.
How much is the answer?
inspector law. Along with you, they will also work. ನಾನು ಇನ್ನ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೆಳಿಲ್ಲ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ನಾನು ಬಿಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಲ್ವಾ ಅಷ್ಟು ಬಿಡೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಅವರೇ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಗುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟ ಸೆವೆನ್ ಫೋರ್ ಒನ್ ನೈನ್ ನೈನ್ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ ಪರ್ This drawing is given. So, problem is half solved. Ready? Question answer. Because drawing after interpretation is what is more important in solving problems on manometers. So, this is given. So, what is asked? And one point before we begin, it is a problem on inverted U-tube manometer. What is the difference between regular U-tube manometer and inverted U-tube manometer? What is opposite? U is inverted. What else is different? Soon put on the top, boys. Here is one of the bottom of the change of triangle concept in the nothing to do. Please remember, most of you may have this in your mind. Nothing to do with the heights of the limbs. Never mattered in mind. I have shown you different examples wherein heights of the limbs doesn't make any difference. It is only whether it is open to atmosphere or not matters. Okay. Now, what is the other major difference I am talking about? The specific gravity of the manometric liquid will be less than that of the liquid whose pressure is to be measured. That is specific gravity 1. Whereas a manometric liquid is having a specific gravity of 0.8. And he says pressure bed at A is 2 meters of water. He has also reduced the burden on you. No question of PA divided by rho w is this, right away we can take it. So what will be the gauge equation? HA plus 30 centimeters you take as H1, 12 centimeters is always H, 10 centimeters is H2. Pressure at B is PB, which you write as HB. What is asked in the problem? To find the pressure at B. Correct? Only once the pressure at B is the loss. Okay, then we solve it. Someone, gauge equation made up with the money.
Send measurement to the side, you get what is are located at
the same level. So sir, assume the pressure at A and B to be equal. Assume the pressure at A and B to be equal.
Minus HB is equal to
minus HP gets cancelled because pressures are same. X will automatically be same. HA HP gets cancelled. SA next one. What is SA? SA is 1.2. If H1 is 0.3. Minus SM is 0.8. H is the one retained. Plus, what is SB? 1. Into what is H2? Very important. H2 is 0.3 plus H. 0.3 plus H.
So, SB is 0.7.
That was what?
0.7
in the moment. Okay. So, J is 0.7. Now I think we can easily solve for H. Tell me what is H? 0.2 na 3 na? 0.3. 0.3 meters of what? Found to be same and equal to 35 centimeter. So stop. Determine the difference of pressure. Determine the difference of pressure between two pipes. Between two pipes. A sort of tricky problem. You read it and then next part. Important line there, that is cement to solve the problem and draw the monumental line. Is it clear that it is an inverted monumental? First point is clear, it is an inverted monumental and there are two pipes in which water is flowing. So in both the pipes we have specific gravity of 1, that is also clear. Next. Okay. You read that line, very important line. Another point that is mentioned is the gauge fluid is 0.8. That is nothing but monometric liquid specific gravity is 0.8. When such a liquid is used to measure the pressure difference between point A and B, how does the arrangement look like? First thing is point A and point B, their axis is 30 cm apart in vertical distance. Either time you want to have point A is there, it is the more centimeters kadagal. So now, when you start measuring the columns of liquid, what are those columns of liquid? H1 and H2. H1 and H2 are measured. When measured from the respective center lines of the pipe, what are respective center lines of the pipe? For pipe A, this is the center line. Now, pipe B, this becomes its center line. When you measure the liquid columns or water columns from the respective center lines, they are found to be equal and are equal to 35 centimeters. So, in the most 10 centimeters, manometric deflection should be visible in this limb. And using that, you will solve the problem. Once you write again, there will be nothing left. So, what is not even the 1 centimeter covered in first place. Okay, now I take 30 centimeters from here and I draw V. You know, this is 30 centimeter, that is nothing but axis of two pipes are 30 centimeters apart in vertical direction. Liquid to same here, look at it here. Next is, when measured from respective center lines, the water column would rise up to 35 centimeters. So starting from here, up to here, it has to be 35 centimeters. Again, you measure from point B, the water column would be up to 35 centimeters. H2 is equal to 35 centimeters. So, center B in the more than centimeter than the center A in the more than centimeter than the other center A and the center B in more centimeter. So, can you tell me how much is this? What is this question? What is to be found out? What is to be found out in the problem? Difference in pressure. That means PA minus PB or PB minus PA has to be found out. For that purpose, H should also be known. How do I find out this H? Yella ila formula answer. How do I find this H? Okay. ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಮೂವತ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ಫೈವ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪೋರ್ಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ಇಫ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೈವ್, ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 35, ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್. ಐ ರಿಪೀಟ್, ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಫೋಕಸ್, ಡು ನಾಟ್ ಲೂಸ್ ದಿ ಫೋಕಸ್. ನೋಡಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ 35 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ನೀರಿದೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ 35 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ತನಕ ನೀರಿದೆ. ಡ್ರಾಯಿಂಗ್ ರೆಡಿ ಆಗಿದೆ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಿದ್ರು ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಿಂಗ್, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 35. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು, ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ 30, ಸೊ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ 5 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ಹಿಯರ್. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಇಲ್ಲಿಂದ 35 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಇದೆ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಈ 5 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ತೆಗೆದ್ರೆ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ 30 ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್. This snack you must have, otherwise you cannot solve the problem. Very simple arithmetic materials. Okay, now we will write the gauge equation and solve. How do we write the gauge equation? Starting from 1 and 10 is SA, where upwards is minus SA H1. Still going upwards, minus SM H. Coming downwards, positive. S B H 2 minus S B is equal to 0. Since I want the difference in pressure between A and B, assuming that H A is greater than H B, I write this as H A minus H B. Do not be upset if this value turns out to be negative 1. It only means that pressure at B is greater than pressure at A. If it comes out to be a positive value, whatever we have understood is that pressure at A is greater than pressure at B. Now, set everything to that side. SA into H1. SA is 1. How much is H1? 0.35. Minus. It into plus 1. SM. SM is 0.8. H2 is specified as 0.8. Into H2. H2 is found to be 30 cm plus nothing but 0.3. If it plus 1, it will be minus 1. SP is also 1. 1 into what is H2? 0.35. This automatically gets cancelled. Yeah, 1 into 0.35 minus 1 into 0.35. What are you? Therefore, HA minus HB is equal to positive answer for that 0.24 meters. Therefore, BA minus B, because I asked you pressure difference, not head difference, is equal to 1000 into 9.81. calculate, if you want to calculate, the gauge pressure and absolute pressure, calculate the gauge pressure and absolute pressure at M. Do not worry about the shape of the manometer. Only thing you must remember is prior to joining into the point, are the two ends open to atmosphere? If yes, they must maintain the same level. Okay? And when connected, if there is a deflection, that deflection is only to be read. That can be solved. So, manometer equation hang with that. You know, how is the gauge equation written? You start from one end. If there is any difference, you consider it. Otherwise, no. If this is a peculiar case, please check. From here to here, you need not consider. Yaw limb, E yaw limb only. But in these two limbs, you must consider this. Because liquids are different. This is very, very important. And the problem is important. Understanding the problem is important because problem is very simple. One drawing only put here. Within one or two steps, you get the answer. But noting the difference between the regular problems and this problem is what is important. For the drawing for the leakage equation on both of them is there. Once you get the pressure, convert the data as you get the pressure. Therefore, absolute is equal to P atmospheric plus PM. P atmospheric is 101.3 into 10 power 3 plus pressure at M is 3940. 1 4 0 5 4 0. No, again, I'm not casual with that. I know it's the last few minutes of the day for you, but that doesn't mean it's a waste.